Wet your hands with water. Apply soap, rub your hands palm to palm, and wash the backs of both hands and in between your fingers. Then palm to palm with fingers interlocked. Clasp your hands together and rub. And then clean around the thumbs too. Rub your fingertips in the palms of your hands and finish off with the wrists. Rinse your hands really well with water and dry them thoroughly with a paper towel. Use the towel to turn off the tap. Your hands are now clean.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Welcome in Islamiyat class. As you know, it is our Islamiyat period. I am Mrs. Amara Zubair. It is our 8th week. First, I want to tell you about the contents. First, we take the review. After that, we will do exercise 2 on book, page number 50. After that, exercise 1, question A and D, short answer on your copy. Question B, C and E, only oral discussion. First, we take the review, our lesson. Generosity. Unit number 11. Our topic is generosity. Islam teaches us to be generous. If you have more than what you need, then it is good to share it with those who do not have much. Our dear Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam was very generous and taught us to be the same. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam led a very simple life. Even though Muslims were ready to lay all their wealth at his feet, he did not use it for himself, but gave it to those who needed it. Muslims left their homes and belongings in Mecca when they migrated to Medina. Ansars, the Muslim of Medina, brought many gifts and food and put these before the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. He distributed them among the needy Muhajirs. In present times, you must have heard of Abdus-Sattar Idi. When he was a young boy, his mother gave him very little money to spend. Even from his little amount, he spent half to help the poor. Idi Sahab is one of the most famous social workers, respected not only in Pakistan but all over the world. There are many people who do not have what we have. Some don't have a home to live in. So let us be generous and share. If you share a room or a cupboard with your brother or sister, don't fight. Share these happily. If your friends visit you, share your toys with them when you play. Don't snatch your things away. If you have a lot of clothes and toys, then it is good to give some to children who do not have any. It is also good to give food, fruits, or sweets to a hungry or a poor family. They may not have the money to buy these. Now, dear students, open your book, page number 50. We will do the exercise 2 word bank has given. With the help of these words, we will complete our blanks. Okay. So, listen these words. Number 1, Ansar. Number 2, Generous. Number 3, Muhajirs. Now, we will start our exercise. Number A. Number A, the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam himself was very generous and taught us to be dash as well. What comes here? We write here generous. We write here generous. G-E-N-E-R-O-U-S. Generous. Number B, Muslims from Mecca who migrated to Medina were called dash. Number B, Muslims from Mecca who migrated to Medina were called. What comes here? Muhajirs. Muhajirs. M-U-H-A-J-I-R-S. Muhajirs. Right here, Muhajirs, M-U-H-A-J-I-R-S, Muhajirs. Number C, Muslims of Medina were called dash. Number C, Muslims of Medina were called dash. Ansar, yes, Muslims of Medina were called Ansar. So, right here, Ansar, A-N-S-A-R, Ansar, A-N-S-A-R, Ansar. Number C, Muslims of Medina were called Ansar, A-N-S-A-R, Ansar. Sab bacho ne exercise complete kar li hai? Good, shabash. Now, dear students, open your notebook. We will do the exercise 1. First, you make margin line. After that, you will start your work. On the first line, you write the name of your lesson, generosity. Okay? Now, we will start our work. Exercise 1. Answer these questions. Question A. What did the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam do with the wealth that people gave him? Listen it again. Question A. What did the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam do with the wealth that people gave him? Ji, iska answer kya hai? Answer, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gave all the wealth to the needy. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gave all the wealth to the needy. The Prophet, P-R-O-P-H-E-T. The Prophet, S-A-W, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gave all the wealth. Gave all the wealth, W-E-A-L-T-H, wealth to the needy. N-E-E-D-Y, needy. Answer, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gave all the wealth to the needy. Listen it again. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gave all the wealth to the needy. Question D. Question D. If you have visitors, will you share your toys with them? Agar aapke se milne koi aaye, to kya aap unke saath apne toys share karenge? Aapne ye lesson mein bhi padha tha na, to wahi question ab aap se hi pucha ja raha hai. Ki agar aapke paas koi guest aate hain, to kya aap unke saath apne toys share karenge? तो करेंगे ना, आप सब तो बहुत अच्छे बच्चे हैं और इसलिए आप जरूर अपने टॉयज अपने फ्रेंड्स के साथ शेयर करेंगे और मिलके खेलेंगे, ठीक है? तो इसका आंसर क्या होगा? यस, आई शैल शेयर माई टॉयज विद देम। क्या आंसर होगा? यस, आई शैल शेयर माई टॉयज विद देम। यस, YES, यस कॉमा आई शैल शेयर माई टॉयज विद देम फुल स्टॉप। आई शैल शेयर माई टॉयज विद देम। Dear dear students, it is your home assignment. You paste the picture of social work, generosity related, and picture of Abdul Sattar Eidi. Okay, it is your home assignment. क्या आप अपनी कॉपी पे सोशल वर्क करते हो, सोशल वर्क की कुछ पिक्चर्स पेस्ट करेंगे और अब्दुल सत्तार ईदी जो हैं उनकी पिक्चर पेस्ट करेंगे, ठीक है बेटा? If you have any question, you can ask your Islamia teacher. Okay. Thank you for listening me. Take care. Allah Hafiz. Fi amanillah.
Assalamu alaikum and good morning everyone. Hope all of you are doing good. I welcome you in our computer science class, lecture 1 of week number 8. And I am your computer science teacher, Ms. Zarmina. Now get ready for your computer science class. Here are the contents. First of all, we are going to revise previous topic. Then today we are going to start new chapter, that is chapter number 8. So the name of chapter is Formatting in WordPad. This chapter is also about the WordPad and about formatting groups in detail. Okay, so today there will be an introduction of a font group and formatting in WordPad. Then book exercise, page number 42, exercise number D. We are also going to attempt an exercise on book, page number 42. And there will be practical activity also. So, my dear students, open your book, page number 36, and get ready. And don't forget to mention date on page number 36, okay? Here are the objectives. So, at the end of the lesson, you will be able to know what is a formatting. Like document formatting refers or it means the way a document is laid out on the page. And you will be able to successfully apply formatting to a document. Okay. At the end of the lessons, our today's objectives are what? To know about what is formatting, what's the meaning of document formatting, and how to apply formatting to a document. So get ready for it. Now we will start with the review. In our previous topic, we studied about how to save document in WordPad. Remember, in our last lecture, we also studied about the keyboard shortcut. So what is the keyboard shortcut? If you want to save your file, keyboard shortcut for saving your file is, yes, everyone is telling me the right answer. That is Control plus S. If you want to save your file in WordPad, what you are going to press? You are going to press Control S. That is a shortcut, keyboard shortcut for saving your file. And we also studied how to save a file from the file menu. Just have to click on the file, then click on save button, and then name your file, and finally click save. This is how you are going to save your document in WordPad or even in Notepad also. And we also studied how to create or open a new document, that is just by clicking on the new, that is in the file group. That button is in file group. And also how to open already saved document. This is also in the file menu. And second option is open. When you click on it, small window will appear and then you can choose whatever file you want to open. So in our previous lecture, we studied about saving your document in WordPad by using different options and buttons from the file menu and also by using the keyboard shortcut. Now it's time for us to start chapter 8, formatting in WordPad. So what's the name of chapter? The name of chapter is formatting in WordPad. So basically, what is the meaning of formatting? So you can also underline it. Formatting text means to make it look beautiful by giving it different colors and changing its size. So what's the meaning of formatting? To make the text look beautiful. How you can make the text look beautiful? By giving it different colors, by changing the style, by increasing the size or by decreasing the size, and even by using highlight, like you can highlight the text. So this is the meaning of formatting text, means to make it look beautiful. And how you can make it look beautiful? By giving it different colors and changing its size, changing the style of the text. So these buttons, or you can say formatting buttons, are in the Home tab. Home tab has so many buttons, as we already studied about the font group, remember? So Home tab has so many buttons and font group is one of them. So Home tab usually help you to format or to arrange. Arrange means to set. Arrange, the meaning of arrange is to set. Okay, so the Home tab has many buttons, as we already knew about them. Clipboard, font group, paragraph group. Remember, these are the buttons in the Home group, and these buttons will help you to format and arrange your text in the document. So these are the names of some font group buttons. Here is a picture also, like these are the pictures and the names of the font group button. Font group button look like this. So it has so many buttons, like font family, or you from here you can change the size, style of the font. You can change the style or the appearance or the look of the text. So this is known as font family. Here you can find a number of different styles. Then number two, font size. That is the font size. From here you are going to make the text bigger or smaller. You can increase the size of your text, or you can even decrease the size. Then this B stands for bold. To make your text thicker, you just have to select this text and click B, that is bold. So all of you have to know the which icon stands for what. Like this B stands for bold. Now italics. Italics means to give, or the sideways, change your text into sideways ways, or even slanting. This is the icon for italics. Underline, if you want to underline your text, you just have to click on it, and the name of this icon or button is underline. I'm telling you again that you have to memorize the name of these buttons, okay? You should know which icon stands for what. And then here you can see A, and there is a black rectangular bar under it, so that is the color, text color. Okay, from here, from this button, you are going to change the color of the text. You just have to click on this drop down arrow, and there you can see a number of different colors like this. Okay, when you click on it, you can see number of colors, like you can select any one of it and change the color of the text. And next is color highlight. There also you can see there is also a drop down arrow. From here you can even change the color of the highlighter. Okay, it works just like the you usually use to highlight any word in your books. Okay, so these are the names of font group. Formatting, you have to format your document with the help of these buttons, and these are in the font group. And if you want, okay, that is about, now we will study in like this one again. Like if you want to underline or make it italics and bold, you just have to click on these buttons, okay? Font size, we are going to revise it again. The name of these buttons, font size, font family, bold. Yes, which is the next one? Yes, italics. Then underline, good. Text color and text highlight color. So these are the names of font group buttons. When you click on the text color drop down arrow, you will see this dialog box. It looks like this, and you can choose any color. If you click on the more colors, you can choose any other color also, which is not right here in these ones. Okay, and bold, to make the bold or to make the text bolder or to look thick. What's the function of bold button? It make the text look darker and thicker. And then italics. Italics to make the text look slanting or sideways. What is the function of italics? It make the text look slanting or sideways. Then underline. What is the function of underline button? It put line under the text. Simply, it put line under the text. So these are the jobs, you can say, or the function of bold, italic, and underline buttons that are in the font group. Okay, so now it's time for you to attempt an exercise that is on book page number 42. Hurry up, open book page number 42 and make sure to sharpen your pencils so your writing will be very neat and clean. So, name any four buttons from the font group. In this exercise, you have to write the name of any four buttons from the font group. So we studied about the font group, and you just have to write the name of any four font group buttons over here. Now, who is going to tell me which is the first one? You can write any one of them. Okay, so the first one will be font size. Font size is in the font group, that's why it is written over here, font size. Now think of another one that is on the font in the font group button, that is bold. Yes, bold is also in the font group button. Now moving on to the third one. So what's the spelling of bold? B-O-L-D, bold. Okay, write carefully and neatly, and don't forget to mention date on exercise number D. Okay, mention date on exercise near exercise D, and then start writing the names of font group buttons. Okay, on number third is underline. Underline. The name of number third group font group button is underline. U-N-D-E-R. Under L-I-N-E. Line. Underline. And finally, the last one is font color. Font color. Okay. You can even write, if you want to write font family, you can write it. And also text color is also in the font group. You can write that one also. Italics is also in the font group. You can write them also. Okay. I'm just showing you the examples how you have to write the names of font group. I've chosen these one like font size, bold, underline, and font color. Okay, do it quickly, and then we will move on to the practical activity. write neatly and carefully, and then we will start our practical activity. So choose any four buttons from the font group. You can write buttons of your own choice also, okay? So hope all of you have done it. Very well done. Now practical activity is it's time for you to perform practical activities. Click on the start menu, then type here word pad. Click on it, and then this is how you are going to open WordPad. Now today we are going to open already saved document. In our previous lecture we studied about it, how to open already saved document. Now today we are going to open that and apply the formatting on that file, and then we are going to save it again. So what you have to do, you have to go into the file menu, and then here you can see recent documents. From the recent documents you can open the file, also from the recent document, and also from this button open that is written. Today I'm going to open file from this button that is open. Click on it, and then you can you will see this window in the documents I saved into the computer folder. Click on it, and here it is, computer exercise 1. I saved my file with the name of this, like computer exercise 1, page number 38. Click on it, and here it is. This is our computer file that is on the Word document. Now today we have to do some of the steps. Like first of all, we have to change the size of this text. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to select all of it. Select it like this. And now we have to change the size into 24. Click on this drop down arrow in the font group, font size, and here it is 24. Just click on it. This is how you are going to change the size. Now you can see it look bigger than the previous one. And we also have to change the style or the font family. Just click on this drop down arrow, and we want to change it into the Arial. So scroll up or down, or even you can write, like just click the mouse pointer over here, backspace. Now I'm going to press backspace from the keyboard, backspace, press it again, and now you can write Arial. AR, like I have just written AR, and now Arial is over here. All of the word is over here. So click on it. Now just press enter. This is also how you are going to select the writing style. Okay, just click on it. You can choose any one of it, or if you can't find, then you can even type the name of that style in this area. Okay, so now we have changed the size. Turn size into 24, and text style is Arial. Now what we have to do, we have to change the color of the text. So in your book exercise page 43, it says that you have to change the first and second line into red color. So I'm just going to select line first and second line. This is how, just click on it and drag the mouse pointer. This is how you're going to select your text, and then go into this one, that is text color. Change the text color. Press on this drop down arrow like this, and move your pointer to the red color. Click on it. Now your color of the first and second line is red. Now we have to change the color of 3rd and 4th line. Similar process, same process. Like select the first line and second line like this. Go again, the text color, drop down arrow, click on it, and select blue color. Now our 5th and 6th line is of green color. We have to choose it for green color. Select it, font group, press drop down arrow, click on the green color, and last line, that is 7 and 8, it will be purple. Okay, now I'm going to select the text again, 7 and 8 line, select go again into the font group, click on drop down arrow, and finally click on the purple. This is how you are going to apply formatting. Like we have changed the size, turned the size into 24, then from this drop down arrow, then font family, and also change the colors of different lines. This is how you are going to change it. Okay, now what you have to do, you have to highlight. Now we are going to highlight all the names that are in this text, like Max. So you have to highlight the word or the names of the person. Like in this over here, it is Max is the name of a person, so you are going to select only Max. Remember, just only select Max, and then go into the font group again. Here is text highlight color, click on it, and Max should be in yellow like this. This is how you are going to highlight. Now there is another name, that is Sam. Again, select the name of a person, Sam, and make it to blue color. Not blue, we will not make into lighter one. Okay, like this. Anne loves car, so Anne is also name of a person. Select it and change its color into red one, like this. Pam loves dog, so Pam is the name of a person. Again, select it and change, or you can highlight it with the pink one, like this. Okay, highlight just the names of the person, and now your document should look like this. This is how you are going to apply formatting tools or format your document. And just now you just have to save that file. Just click on it, just click on this save button, or you can go into the file and save from here, or even you can press Control S. Okay, that is it. You just have to press it like this and save it, and click cross it, close the file, and your file will be saved in your same place with the same name. You just don't have to give the name again, because we have opened that file is being already saved. Okay, so we were doing this exercise, that is on page number 43 and 44. You have to same apply the apply formatting, like number one, start the document that is saved before, change font family and size, then change the colors of different line, just I have done right now, similar. Okay, that was it. Now it's preview time. In our next lesson, we are going to start new topic, that is about paragraph group buttons. So chapter 8, page number 40. We are going to start in our next lecture formatting in WordPad. Chapter is the same, and topic is about paragraph group buttons. Today we studied about font group buttons. In our next lesson or lecture, we are gonna start new topic, that is about paragraph group buttons, and also we will perform practical activity, and that is on page number 40. And also we are going to attempt exercise A, B, and C, that will be on page number 42. Okay, now it's time for homework. What you have to do, you have to open already saved file and apply the formatting. Like today, what we have done in the practical activity, you have to apply the same formatting and save that file. Okay, that is your home task. Now it's time for you to ask questions, okay? If you have any questions related to today's lecture, you can ask in WhatsApp group. And thank you for listening. Take care of yourselves. Allah Hafiz.